Hey, it's Kurt at the Top Corner Hockey Studios. Thanks for watching. This is a video I've wanted to do for a long time, finally getting around to it, and it's going to be awesome because I'm doing the top 10 most exciting hockey players ever. So obviously there's a difference, right? I'm not telling you who I think are the top 10 best hockey players ever, or in that order. I'm just telling you who I think are just so much fun to watch. Now, they're all offensive geniuses, these guys. If you're the type of hockey fan that enjoys watching strong defensive play and you find that exciting, you're not going to find that on this list. All these players on this list were fabulous goal scorers. Now, some of them were multifaceted hockey players, but for the most part, we're talking about guys that scored beautiful goals over and over again through their careers that were just so much fun to watch. The type of players that you would fork over your money to see, your time to see, because this is what made the sport of hockey a lot of fun. What's great about this video is that we're just going to watch awesome goals being scored just over and over again by some of the most exciting players of all time, the players who I feel are the most exciting players of all time. I had a blast making this video. I hope you have fun watching it. Let's take a look. Wayne Gretzky, 99, is a unique entry on this list. He's not here because he scored tons of beautiful goals like the others, but simply because he scored so much and so often. When you're piling up points like no one else in hockey ever has, you're going to generate crazy high levels of excitement on the ice, in the stands, and in the media. Wayne was the type of hockey player people paid to see wherever he played, and he was worth the ticket price. Guy Lafleur. The image of Guy Lafleur flying down the wing with the hair flowing is worthy of its legendary fondness. Lafleur would burn down the wing, backing off defenders, giving him space to rip shots on goal, many of them finding the back of the net. Lafleur's great speed and shot helped him earn 6 50-goal seasons and electrify crowds for a decade. Sergei Fedorov. For some of the younger hockey fans, I'm curious to know how well Sergei Fedorov's career has held up over the years. In the 90s, he was so flipping awesome. FedEx had great speed and magic hands. He scored a ton of goals, and so many of them were beautiful. Fedorov scored over 30 goals 10 times in his career, hitting a career high of 56 in the 93-94 season, and he won the Hart Trophy that year. As of 2018, Fedorov is still the highest scoring Russian-born player of all time. Jaromir Jagr. For the first half of his career, few players were as dynamic with the puck as Jagr. Those 11 years in Pittsburgh brought hockey fans a boatload of beautiful goals. Once he got out of Mario's shadow, it seemed like Jagr was scoring a goal of the year kind of goal every week. Because Jagr was such an offensive driver, and because he had more moves than a dance party, he was the NHL's main attraction there for a few years in the late 90s and early 2000s. Pavel Datsyuk. I can hear some of you right now. How in the world is Pavel Datsyuk down at number 6? I bet some of you believe he's the clear choice for number 1. I just think this goes to show how great some players are, that at least 5 players are better with the puck than a man called the Magic Man. No question, Datsyuk was a treat to watch. Many of his goals are classics, and deservedly so. Not many players fooled their opponents as well and as often as Datsyuk did. The 3-time 30-goal scorer turned more guys around than I can remember. And some of the goals he scored are some of my favorite all-time goals. Sidney Crosby, the best player of his generation and one of the best of all time, Sidney Crosby's relentless style, tremendous talent, and offensive totals have made him one of the most exciting players I've ever seen. No one protects the puck like Sid, and his creativity and vision and skill mean he's generated some of the most memorable moments on the ice in the post-lockout era and of all time. I make a point of watching as many Pittsburgh Penguin games as I can just so I can watch Sidney Crosby. He's done stuff with the puck I've never seen another hockey player do, and it never gets old, no matter how many times I rewatch his work. Bobby Hull. Like Lafleur, the scene of the golden jet racing down the ice with his blonde mane rippling in the wind is a real sight to behold. Hull's tremendous speed and big shot brought hockey fans everywhere to their feet. I can only imagine what it would have been like in the 60s in the old Chicago Stadium when Hull grabbed the puck and started heading up ice. His power was too much for the NHL in his day, as defenders found themselves unable to keep up with him or even knock him off the puck. Hull's big shot would then knock people right out of their skates. Pavel Bure. I've never seen a player go from standing still to just flying like Pavel Bure. I think he's probably the fastest player in that aspect. No question, Bure was one of the most exciting goal scorers ever. His speed was remarkable, but he also possessed great stick handling skills and he had a great shot. Pavel could beat defenders in so many ways, either by just racing past them or turning them inside out. Injuries limited him to only 8 full seasons, and he still scored over 50 goals 5 times. Mario Lemieux. Scotty Bowman once said he's seen a lot of big hockey players and a lot of highly skilled hockey players, but he's never seen a player blend size and skill like Mario Lemieux did. Lemieux used his size to keep the puck out of reach, but his tremendous dexterity allowed him to control the puck like he had it on a string. His incredible accuracy was the best I've ever seen. No one could put it in a shoebox like Mario. And when Lemieux was on a breakaway, the goalie had no chance at all. He was completely helpless. Lemieux on a breakaway was about as sure thing as you could get in hockey. The most exciting player of all time, no question about this one, it's Bobby Orr. He's the greatest hockey player of all time and the fastest of all time too. No one had a higher top-end speed than Robert Gordon Orr. He was unstoppable. No one would toy with his opponents like Orr could. He only gave up the puck if he wanted because no one was ever taking it from him. His outrageous speed and stick handling combined with his bullet shot gave Orr a combination of talents no one else has ever had, at least not at the unattainable heights Bobby Orr acquired. His skating ability, his vision are simply that much better than anyone else who's ever played the game. Every time Orr touched the puck, the crowd went nuts because he did something very special and very unique with it so often. It is impossible to get tired of watching Bobby Orr highlights. I've seen them a zillion times and it's like watching them for the first time all over again every time I watch them. As much fun as this list was to make, because I'm putting in just piles of beautiful goals and talking about some of the most exciting players of all time, I had to leave some guys out, of course. I have to do it for every top 10 list. So I know I can hear some of you actually writing right now saying, where in the heck is Alex Ovechkin? Good question. I mean, it's a good point, right? I believe Ovechkin is one of the most exciting players of all time. He scored a ton of goals, and a lot of them are beautiful goals. But a lot of them are also one-timers from the left circle on the power play, which is not that exciting. So that bumped him down a little bit. One player I hated leaving off this list was Gilbert Perreault. Just like the other older players on this list that I never got to see, the highlights and what I've read about Gilbert Perreault are astonishing. I can just imagine what it would have been like at the Odd in Buffalo in the 70s, watching Perreault race down the ice, because he was fast and he was a tremendous stick handler. I remember watching an old-timers game in the 90s, and there were two things I remember from this old-timers game. One was that Maurice Richard was the referee, and the other one was watching a 40-something-year-old Gilbert Perreault do whatever he wanted with the puck. Now, I know some of you are probably saying, okay, it's an old-timers game, so what? You could still see the tremendous talent that Perreault had, and he was fun to watch as a 40-something-year-old in a charity game. I can just think what it would have been like to watch him in his prime. He was probably so awesome. Another exciting player I had to leave off this list was Maurice Richard. Although not a lot of highlights are from Richard's era, just like Wayne Gretzky, scored so many goals that people were probably pouring through gates in the original six era to watch Maurice Richard play because they probably felt he was going to do something special that night. Who do you think is the most exciting, or some of the most exciting hockey players of all time? Was there anyone you felt I missed from this list? Please continue to like and subscribe. I'm Kurt, this is Top Corner Hockey. Thanks for watching, see you next time.